So what you see here is I've taken this image and used the broader brushes to cover it up. And the way I did was basically press L to get the lasso tool. Say, select an area, then press B, and then press Alter Options, choose your color or tone and shade, and press Shift F5 and press Enter, because normally your foreground color is over here, the tone or color that you've chosen, and press Enter or Return. That space is filled up. You can press Control or Command D for deselect. So L for the lasso tool, the area you want to cover. Then you press B and Alter Option. Alter Option to choose the tone. Shift F5 to fill it in. Then Command or Control D to deselect. Let me repeat it. L for the lasso tool. And you can actually go back and forth in L. See over here, if you see on this on the tool palette, you can Shift L and you can go back and forth. So you get L for the lasso tool. Then you press B, or you can go directly to the eyedropper tool. So you can go to I from there, select the tone, and then Shift F5 to fill it up. Control or Command T to deselect. Then you can go to B and you can use the bracket key to minimize. You can use the mixer brush. Bracket key. Bracket key is really helpful. You can increase and decrease the size, so you don't have to go all the way. So once you've done the broader fill, the way to colorize it is create a new layer. You go here, after you've chosen a layer. This is your blend mode. Click on it and go to color. Go to your original image. Press I to select the tone you want. Maybe go for a darker tone. Go back here and start colorizing it. Click on I and then go back. So this is a very easy way of getting, using I and other keyboard shortcut, you can hold I and then go over. And what you can do is you can use a softer brush for these areas. Holding I and rolling over, you can see the color you really want. And using broader strokes,